This is truly a historic occasion for the state of Minnesota, for the future of our university, and I think we all know that this trench we're going to dig is also going to establish a foundation for the future of high energy physics and science, not just here, but around the world.
University of Minnesota President Robert Brunix is talking about the Nova neutrino detector that, thanks to $40 million from the Department of Energy, is being built near the Ash River in northern Minnesota. The Nova laboratory will house a 15,000-ton particle detector that will investigate the role of subatomic particles called neutrinos in the origin of the universe.
We make a neutrino beam at Fermilab, and we shoot it through the Earth, no tunnel, just right straight through the Earth, because neutrinos don't like to interact with matter anyway. And it comes up, you know, here at our detector in Ash River in this building that we're about to break the ground on.
The beam starts at the Fermilab outside of Chicago. Its last stop used to be the underground Minos detector in Sudan, Minnesota. It continues on a line to the northwest, where it will now meet the Nova site.
And so the neutrino beam, which is made at the accelerator at Fermilab, is actually aimed at the Sudan detector, and which is half a mile underground. That's why it was easy to select this site. We just followed the beam line and went 12 kilometers off it and picked a nice high hill to build our building on, and that's how we selected the Nova site.
The kind of neutrinos we make at Fermilab are one kind called muon neutrinos, and we're looking to see if they turn into another kind up here called electron neutrinos.
The first question everybody asks is, you know, what good does this do us directly? And there really is no direct answer. It may be the missing piece of some puzzle that's going to answer an important question that's 10 or 15 or 20 years down the line. This may be some important piece. Since we don't know the answer now, we don't really know what it is. It doesn't mean you shouldn't look, and it's just the questioning nature of people to try and understand everything and how it works.
The money for the project is coming to the U of M as part of the Federal Recovery and Reinvestment Act.
I would argue that the work that goes on here and the work that goes on throughout the University of Minnesota system is vitally important to the economy of our state and nation.
It'll create probably around 30 full-time jobs for the couple of years it takes to build the detector, and then kind of 6 to 10 full-time jobs for another 10 to 15 years. So there'll be some good jobs for some people, and we're just looking for good workers.